back to my channel. This is the first time I'm shooting my video in the new year, 2023. Happy New Year, because I haven't said that in my last video. With the new year, I kind of just wanted to focus a little bit on the motto of like new year, new me. Makanya di video kali ini, I'm implementing a lot of, you know, good habits, healthy habits. It's a new year, it's a new you, it's a new habit, it's a new mindset, right? It's a new personality. My two vlogs before, aku bilang kan mudah-mudahan di tahun 2023 kita semua tuh bisa memperbaiki diri, kan? Dan itu semua tuh gak bisa menjadi omongan doang. Kita tuh harus benar-benar ngelakuin juga untuk bisa memperbaiki diri kita sendiri. OTW mau ke Paris. Ini sekarang jam 2 siang di tanggal Januari berapa nih? 6. Dan lagi cantik banget New York. Okay. Dan udaranya lagi enak banget, lagi dingin tapi kayak enggak lebay dinginnya gitu. Lagi enak banget hari ini. Aku cuma pakai satu layer doang. Dan I'm a little bit early, jadi aku mau muter-muter dikit sambil mau belanja kali ya. Kalau that habit of like wasting my money, that's not gonna go away. That's still gonna be here. So, I'll see you guys later. So this is it. Kita di Solid Core. Just
open out those elbows out. Close those elbows in. Nice and slow. Nice and slow. These look amazing. You put it together in 3, 2. Bicep curls up. These look good, these look good. Keep going. Can you get 1 inch lower in that left leg? Yes, you can. Yes, you can. That was great.
Jadi, aku baru selesai. Hari ini susah banget olahraga ya. Susah banget. Dan aku tuh perutnya tuh lagi kayak sore banget, lagi kayak kram. Terus juga kaki-kaki aku tuh kram banget. It was a good exercise.
First, to improve your body and health, it has to come from your food. Right now, I'm grocery shopping in Trader Joe's, this very famous grocery shop place. Ngantrinya tuh panjang banget ya, selalu di sini. Panjang banget. But lately, I've been trying to, you know, add a lot of vegetable, greens, fruits into my daily diet. Kalau mau itu pun salad, kadang-kadang kalau misalnya lagi makan siang, in between breaks ya. Jadi kesan aku kalau lapar daripada nge-snack nyemil-nyemil gak jelas, mending makan salad gitu kan. Atau juga kalau misalnya aku lagi makan nasi pakai lauk, I try to add more vegetables into my plate. Dan sekarang aku lagi sering-seringnya banget nih focus on like my mental health juga. Right now I listen to a lot of podcasts that can like kind of like improve my mindset and stuff, and I usually do that in like coffee shops where I spend like alone time with myself just to think. I'm so in love, because I think having like a good health is also having a good mindset. Like the way that you think is also very, very important.
Okay, well, we're like having a slow day today. I'm kind of chilling in a park right now. This is called Union Square. Then I kind of just want to talk with you guys a little bit. I was having like a crisis today. Gak tahu tadi pas aku lagi kerja atau aku lagi mikir kayak, oh my god, it's so hard being an adult. Kayak aku kan sekarang kayak semua grocery shop, semua belanja rumah, semua kan aku bayar sendiri kan. Then sometimes I think it's like I think to myself, wow, this is great that I'm doing this and I'm able to do that. Dan kayak bersyukur banget. But at the same time, aku tuh kangen banget masa muda di mana kayak I have no care in the world. All I did, all that I was stressed about is like if I'm gonna get a good grade in my homework. That's literally what I want right now. And it's so crazy. Aku bentar lagi tuh umur 22 tahun. Then I feel like I've achieved nothing in life, to be honest. And maybe it's a good and bad thing to kind of see it from that way. Kayak sometimes kita tuh harus, mungkin di tahun baru ini kita juga kadang-kadang harus kayak reflect back apa sih yang kita sebenarnya udah achieve, apa sih yang kurang gitu loh. Tapi jangan terlalu ngedorong kita ke bawah. Kita juga harus pikir, okay, we've done a lot for ourselves, you know, we've worked our ass off, let's celebrate. But like, it's important to kind of reflect and see the stuff that needs to be worked on. Anyways, I'm getting so deep. Ini gue habis pilates jadi kayak dalam banget. And I just wanted to tell you guys that, but yeah.
Good morning, guys. So this is the next day already, and it's like 10 a.m. And sekarang aku lagi preparation for a job interview in an hour. Aku dari kemarin tuh, I've been applying to like new jobs kan, kerjaan baru. Karena I feel like in my current job right now di TikTok, it's a great job, but I feel like I'm not going anywhere. Kayak there's no room untuk aku kayak misalnya naik pangkat di gitu-gitu lah. I feel like I'm just stuck here for a year and I've made no improvements, or like, I don't know, it's just not the kind of job I want to do. So I've been applying to like different jobs, and aku udah dari kemarin tuh kayak ngelakuin beberapa interview gitu kan. Tapi sayangnya aku tuh apply banyak banget ya kerjaan. By the way, ini kalau kalian misalnya mau nanya, ya kak, cara apply kerja di sana tuh gampang gak sih? Jawabannya adalah enggak, susah banget. Aku apply mungkin udah ada kayak 50 kerjaan. Aku cuman baru ngelakuin 3 interview dari 50 itu. Ya, jadi yang lain tuh bener-bener ditolak gitu sama mereka. Gak tahu kenapa, mereka gak bilang. Mungkin ada beberapa yang skills aku gak cocok sama mereka, atau misalnya juga karena aku international student. Kan kayak kalau misalnya kita lagi apply kerjaan, kita tuh bisa ditanya kan, apakah kita membutuhkan sponsorship in the future, gitu kan. Dan aku emang butuh sponsorship karena aku orang internasional. Dan mungkin karena aku jawabnya iya, aku butuh sponsorship, mereka kayak, oh no, we don't sponsor our employees, gitu. Makanya jadi enggak. Tapi ya mungkin, maybe I'm just underqualified mungkin juga, gitu kan. Tapi dari 3 interview yang aku dapat ini, 2 yang kemarin tuh aku nggak lolos ke ronde berikut. Jadi aku cuma dikasih satu interview, aku ngelakuin interviewnya terus nggak lolos, gitu kan. Nah, yang ini aku lagi ngelakuin interview terakhir, step terakhir. Ya, jadi dari kemarin tuh aku udah ada sempat 2 kali interview lolos, dan ini interview terakhir. Mudah-mudahan banget aku dapat yang ini karena I'm kind of confident. Dan dari kemarin tuh benar-benar berdoa banget aku mendapatkan job ini karena aku pengen banget lowongan ini.
So my interview is in like 10 minutes and I'm already all prepped in my station and ready to go.
Jujur aku ada agak deg-degan sih,
but it's okay, I'm prepared, and hopefully, I really hope aku tuh bisa bagus banget di interview ini, because I really want the job. Doain guys, amin.
How are you?
I'm doing great, how are you?
Good. How do I pronounce your name?
It's Kanya.
Kanya.
Yeah.
How pretty. I would love you to walk us through your resume.
I would start by saying that my passion kind of lies in like marketing and PR, you know, the whole shenanigan of like writing, communicating with customers, creating content that captures ideas and selling points. I had the opportunity to get my hands on and applying like my creative outlet to capture customers' attention and growth, in which I was able to grow one of the company social media that I was interning for. They're following by like 60%. I'm currently in my first job out of college, currently a user operation associate for TikTok.
Can you share an example of a time when you had to be a deliverable in a really tight time frame?
In my last internship, I was given the responsibility of like multiple projects from like different teams, such as being in charge of like content ideas and reviewing drafts for a YouTube channel that we had to post like twice a week, and then reviewing and editing monthly magazine editions, and also launching campaigns for our subsidiary companies. A lot of pressure, and my manager had like really high expectations. But I was able to get through it all. But I think to me, the most important thing is to have like a meaningful system in my work. Something that I can kind of just like rely on when I'm not sure what to do next. I don't hesitate to kind of like ask my coworkers or my supervisors for help too, in cases where maybe my workload is just too much. And I think that's an important aspect too. I think we're here as a group.
Have you ever received feedback that was constructive from a leader or from a peer? And if so, how did you implement that feedback?
Do take constructive criticism very, very well, I would say. I think it's always a good thing to kind of, you know, have feedback from like your coworkers, from your like managers, especially in a professional setting. I never take it like
personally, we're all here to kind of do good for the company or like for the organization that we're working on. It's never nothing personal. I think I did great on some of them, but I kind of bodge some juga. Okay, there were some yang kayak not in my plan, not in my planning, that I kind of just mumbled a little bit. But I think with my personality and like how friendly I was, mudah-mudahan keterima. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Gue sampe garuk-garuk kepala anjir, bener-bener takut banget woy.
Dan aku sekarang udah ganti lokasi nih, kita sekarang lagi di downtown, di Financial District. Nih, the downtown of Manhattan. Ini sini semua isinya kantor-kantor semua ya. Nah dan hari ini sekarang aku lagi mau kasih lihat kalian kantor di New York City itu seperti apa ya. Karena aku tuh dari kemarin belum pernah kasih tahu, gara-gara aku kalau kerja kan fully online kan. Aku tuh kerja di rumah total gitu. Tapi temen aku ada yang kerjanya di sini. Nih, di World Trade Center, 3 World Trade Center. Dan hari siapa di Jumat tuh dia bisa ada tamu gitu datang ke kantor ya. Jadi aku bilang, "Git, aku mau dong datang ke kantor kamu biar aku bisa kasih lihat kalian aja gitu kan. Suasana kerja di New York City tuh seperti apa?" Ya, kantornya. Terus nyampe, mari kita lihat kitanya di mana nih.
Ini dia suasana Financial District di bawah.
Masukin tiketnya. Enggak goblok. Masuk. Kan pegangin.
Dia Gita, kantornya Gita. Iya. Yeah. Si Bebep. Give a little background dari ini kantornya. Kantornya kerja apa?
Di company Hudson River Trading.
Kayak itu company Hudson River Trading. Ya, yeah, terus
kerjanya recruiting operations.
Oke. Okay. Gila, lihat ya nih elevatornya. Udah bener-bener kalau kalian nonton film gitu kan, orang kerja di New York nih, Gita nih seperti itu ya. Tapi gimana experience kerja lo?
Capek sih kerja sama orang. Tapi ya good experience.
Good experience. Money-nya good gak?
Boleh lah. I mean office-nya bagus banget sih.
Iya, itu plus ya. Terus kita bakal lihat nanti kita tuh bisa dapat setiap hari, bisa dapat free stuff, makanan gratis, ada sampo gratis, gitu-gitu kan.
Sampo gym gratis. Enak sih, benefits ya.
Oke, mari kita lihat nih. Kita lantai
76. Aduh, gila,
tinggi
sakit
banget.
Iya, cepat harus check in, guys.
Ya, ini tadi aku dapat tiket.
Harus check.
Nih. Okay, jadi ini, what is this? Is this like the common area where you eat? Okay, so basically this is like the cafeteria. Tuh, kosong sih gitu ya, udah pada pulang. Ini biasanya siang-siang rame.
Rame banget.
Ini pantry, apa, banyak makanan-makanan. Banyak banget, di stok banget sama mereka, woy.
Setiap jam tuh pasti ada yang masukin lagi.
Hah, serius?
Sumpah.
Ada bir juga di kantor.
Wait, ini nih.
Ini wine. Terus orang anjir ada wine, terus orang casually drinking wine gitu in the middle of like work. Oh ya?
Yeah?
Siang-siang atau udah kayak after?
Boleh, malam-malam boleh. It's always
good. Yeah, look at this.
Snacknya juga gila tuh. Kayak dirapiin terus loh.
Gila sih. Enak banget. Ada makanan juga. Biasanya apa? Makanannya apa biasanya?
Ada apple, Asian, salmon.
Beda-beda gitu kan. Nice. Bagus banget guys kantornya.
Semua sereal guys.
Gue sih ambil-ambilin.
Ya makanya gue bilang gue datang buat mencuri ya nih.
Enak.
Emang mereka ekstranya tuh kayak gitu guys. Ini kalau ambil ya, satu pack woy. Nggak per piece.
Iya, ya iyalah.
Ya tapi kayak Ghirardelli mahal sih.
Oh iya sih, mereka juga satuan gitu ya.
Ya.
Jadi di sini kita ada yang namanya game room. Lucu banget.
Terus ada gymnya guys.
Lucu banget. Ini bener-bener yang kayak kantor kayak gini tuh.
Ekstra banget guys, lu harus tahu.
First of all, ini gara-gara it's a startup kan, dan juga tech company. Jadi tech company itu biasanya tuh go extra lah, kayak
kayak Google gitu-gitu. Dan sebenarnya TikTok aku tuh juga di LA kayak gini, tapi saya aku nggak di sana. Tapi kayak these companies tuh kayak bener-bener value, like ya ada gymnya juga
dan toiletnya.
Ini lebih bagus daripada apartemen lo, kemarin gue terlihatnya.
Jauh lo, gila lo.
Ini banyak banget yang nge-gym.
Banyak kita semua sepatu gym lo.
Jadi orang tuh habis kerja gitu ya, gitu. Biasanya pagi-pagi sebelum.
Sebelum atau sesudah tuh, sampo-sampo yang dicuri tuh anjing.
Bagus gitu kantor lo.
Iya kan? Enggak, tapi emang ini jarang guys. Gue tuh hoki, gak semua kantor kayak gini.
Iya.
Masih tapi, banyak yang kayak kotak-kotak-kotak doang.
Kalau yang lain kantor-kantor kayak misalnya Jason gitu-gitu.
Wah, itu benar depresi banget kan. Kayak cuman kotak-kotak-kotak laptop-laptop sebelahan gitu loh.
Di sini tuh mereka really push like well-being, like as long as you're doing your work and also have like a good time in the office gitu. Which is really nice.
Ya, dan enggak ada kayak kalau lu jam 9 harus sampai. Boleh kayak jam 11. You mau nginep di sini juga. They don't care.
Ini kopi.
Rata-rata introvert sih, anak-anak sih.
Pasti nerd-nerd gitu gak?
Ya, nerd banget, yang gak pernah kayak lihat cewek gitu loh. Ya kayak, sumpah.
Terus yang lain, bukan yang bukan timo di sini kayak kerjanya jadi apa? IT-nya cuman gitu-gitu, apa?
Algo sama core.
Apa itu?
Ya yang bikin the database.
Oh ya, itu fix nerds-nya sih.
Oh my god, kerjanya bisa up to base $300,000 plus 1% of every trading made with the algo. Jadi total bisa $3 juta per tahun fresh graduate. Itu gila sih.
Anjing, itu apa computer science gitu ya, komsai gitu-gitu ya. Anjing. Kenapa ya gue ngambil komsai dulu? Enggak bisa.
Walaupun mau ngambil kayak lu enggak bakal deh. Mereka cuma accept dari kayak Ivy League tuh, Harvard, Stanford, MIT.
Ini future note to my daughters or sons udah.
Harus dulu, like, harus ID masuk komsai. MIT.
Udah lah, enggak usah.
Tapi jadi aneh tau anaknya. Gue sih gak mau. Oh mereka ya, kalau lunch aja mereka coding guys.
Anjing.
Mereka duduk kayak berlima sambil makan sambil coding. Kayak mereka emang cinta. Oh, gue gak ngerti sih kan.
Tapi gue gak apa-apa sih dapet cowok kayak gitu yang kayak.
Gue juga gak apa-apa.
Lo bilang, ih tapi orangnya aneh tapi gak apa-apa aneh gitu dengan gajinya.
Iya terus pasti pinter banget.
Woohoo, so you're looking at up, ke up ya, uptown gitu. So that tall building is Empire State. And my house di ujung.
Bagus sih. Nih si datang si kape tiba-tiba bawa backpack, gue kira dari kantor kan dia. Abis kerja. Enggak, dari rumah loh. Dia bawa backpack untuk masukin ini semua nih. Ketahuan cipe. Gak apa-apa, ambil aja pe. Ayo pe. Nih kita masuk. Karena udah gak ada orang di sini. Jadi ini this is where people work. Mana nak, kok nintak udah gak ada? Hotel desk.
Soalnya kita ada interns, jadi harus kasih meja ke interns.
Ini meja ya, kita bisa kerja di sini. Ini selalu rame, enggak ya?
Enggak, kosong. Tergantung sih harinya.
Nice. Boleh WiFi di sini ya?
Boleh lah.
Ya kita meeting dulu, meeting adjourned.
Ini biasa buat classroom gitu.
Nice. Nah nih guys, kalau kalian lihat nih, this is downtown, right? So we are like here, right? And that's your building, gak sih?
Yeah. Tap to whiteboard.
Okay, so in today's agenda, we're gonna be talking about Gita's work ethic that's so bad. Let's fix that.
Annyeong.
Halo guys, balik lagi sama gue Kania Panani. Dan hari ini gue mau
kamera handling
banget
ya.
Kamera handling
kita nyebelin banget ya sih.
Nah, kan itu kan tinggal di-cut entar. Udah, matiin.
Iya.
Lalu langsung.
Oh shit.
Misalkan. Oh, ini juga mau ya? Disarat ya?
Gue kira gue lembek. Terus gue
weekday brunch with Caitlin and Sarah. We're at what's it called? Bubby's?
Bubby's.
Bubbies, this is the place. It's in Tribeca. So cute. And a little brunch with pancakes and eggs and potatoes? What's that? Oh, bread.
I don't know.
That's good.
Very good.
Hi, Sarah. I haven't seen her in a long time. Finally, to improve myself, it is also very important for me to keep my surrounding with positive vibes only. In 2023, we do not need toxic people in our life. We keep the ones that keep us happy, that keep us positive, that keeps motivating us and pushing us to become a better person. Because what are friends if they're not there to, you know, make you become a better you? And of course, to have a good laugh, because that's also very important.
Tadi kita berantem sama sopir-sopir. Share dong di NYC.
Introduce yourself.
My name is Sebastian. Instagramnya Sebastian Chu. Lu kalau mau know more about me, follow my IG. Tapi gue belum itu.
Cocok nggak?
Gue belum accept sih.
Oke. Cocokan gue sama siapa?
Ini option 1. Next.
Dia.
Option 2. Okay, next.
Gak bakal.
Option. Option 3. I vote for 3. Next. Ini udah skip sih anjing. 4. Skip. Dah. Ini aja.